Whether they're cute as a button or have a face only a parent could love, the ocean is full of babies, big and small. And if they're able to survive those perilous first days and weeks of life, they'll chart a unique path through the sea, which is why each and every one of these newborns has a birth story worth telling. So let's start at the beginning, with the birds and bees under the sea. Many animals in the ocean produce the next generation through sexual reproduction, the joining of eggs and sperm. These reproductive cells each contain genetic material, which combine to create a new life, a slightly different version from both parents. Though this fertilization process sometimes happens inside a female's body, when it comes to the ocean, most of the time it happens right out in the open. Quite a few of the deep blue's inhabitants, including all kinds of fish, corals, sea urchins, mussels, and numerous others, create the next generation in a synchronized swirling soup of eggs and sperm, otherwise known as spawning. Often timed with the cycles of the moon, millions of eggs can get fertilized this way, mingling new genetic mixes that spread far and wide. But there are other critters living below the waves who are able to make the next generation all by themselves. And they don't require eggs or sperm, because instead of blending together genetic material from two parents, these individual animals are able to clone a copy of themselves through asexual reproduction. There are a few different ways that they create these mini-me's. Some anemones and sea cucumbers can split themselves into two parts and then regenerate the missing half in a process called fission. Fragmentation happens when a piece of an animal, like the arm of this sea star, breaks off and regenerates into a whole new individual. Corals do it a bit differently. They grow little buds called polyps that, once big enough, separate from the parent and start their own colony. But getting back to those soon-to-be-born babies, what happens next? Well, if they're in an egg, they'll hatch. Some of those eggs make their way into the world alone, sometimes adrift in the water, or buried in ocean sediments. But other eggs are well cared for. Like angelfish eggs, whose parents are mouth brooders. They hold their fertilized eggs in their muzzles until the eggs are ready to hatch. Or octopus eggs. This eight-armed mom protects and aerates her brood right up until the very end, when they hatch and she dies. But if the little oceanic bundles of joy develop in their mother's body instead of in an egg, they're delivered through a live birth. Like whale and dolphin babies who are typically born tail first. That way, there's less of a chance they'll drown. Capable of swimming from the first moment, newborn whale calves get a little help from their moms to rise to the surface and take their first breath. And because there's always an exception to every rule, seahorse babies, called fry, are carried in and emerge from their father's bellies, one of the only animals in the world to do so. But not all ocean-dwelling animals are born in the sea. Some are born in rivers, on ice, and even on land before finding their homes below the waves. Depending on the species, some ocean tots are tiny, like these brittle star larvae, who are about as wide as a grain of salt, while others are some of the biggest babies on Earth, like this blue whale behemoth, who's about as long as a limousine at birth. And these not-so-little ones grow quickly, too. Thanks to all that fatty milk they drink from their moms, blue whale calves gain about 10 pounds an hour, or about 200 pounds a day. Some nautical newborns look like mini versions of their adult selves, while others are totally unrecognizable, like these baby sea urchins. A good number of ocean babies need to learn how to feed, care, and protect themselves before they can go out into the big blue on their own. Like sea otter pups, who rely for months on their moms to keep them alive and keep their bellies full. Or some types of killer whales who stay with their moms not just as babies, but for life, leaving her side as adults only for short stints to look for food or to mate. But other sea tots, like baby seahorses, sea turtle hatchlings, shark pups, and most coral reef fish fry, are on their own from the get-go, including all those spawned drifters, otherwise known as plankton, many of whom sow their wild oats early on, floating in the currents before settling down in the sea. Odds are, most of those spawned offspring and their millions of siblings won't survive very long. And they're not the only ones with poor prospects. Roughly 1 in 100 baby fish or octopuses make it to maturity. About half that number of seahorses survive. And only 1 in 1,000 sea turtles live long enough to have their own babies. Even those animals whose parents invest a ton of care in their offspring lose many of their babies. There's no doubt about it, the ocean does not coddle its young. But for all the babies who don't make it, many others beat the odds and survive to create the next generation of ocean inhabitants in that great circle of life that spirals on above and below the waves.